A bipartisan pair of state lawmakers have a plan to improve Florida's mental health with a bill next year. It's a goal that has a simple one: better inform families that help is out there. Capitol reporter Forrest Saunders has the story tonight from Tallahassee.
Florida's national mental health rankings could be better. The annual assessment from nonprofit Mental Health America places Florida in the bottom half of states, ranking us 28th. That MHA report shows Florida struggles most with mental health access, ranking 49. Officials finding many adults and children with illnesses didn't receive treatment despite having insurance. Florida law already funds public schools to connect students with mental health services, but lawmakers worry not enough are taking advantage because they don't know it's there.
We all know that if we have a physical health issue, we call our doctor, but not everybody's sure where to go if they're having a mental health problem.
That's Rep. Christine Hunchofsky. She's partnered with Senator Gail Harrell to change things during the next session. They filed bills this week simply requiring schools to notify a student's parents or caregivers of the local behavioral health options up for grabs and that they may qualify for. Hunchofsky hoping the whole family will benefit.
You can't just give help to the student. You need to give help to their entire environment, often in these cases. And it's just making sure people are aware of the resources available to them so they can take advantage of them.
The bipartisan partnership will likely give the bills an edge in the GOP-controlled legislature. Plus, the two are hopeful the governor will support the effort.
$421 million for school safety and for mental health initiatives.
As he seeks to boost school mental health dollars by $20 million in the next year's budget.
So we're very excited about that.
Lawmakers will consider it all in just a few more weeks when they return to the Capitol. They filed thousands of bills so far, and more than 90 touch on mental health. The legislative session starts January 11th, and one of the first things on the agenda is the governor's State of the State address, in which he'll lay out his priorities for 2022. That's the latest out here at the Capitol. I'm Forrest Saunders reporting.